हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ सुलेख शर्मा फ्रॉम CSE डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ECB कॉलेज बीकानेर। टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट शेड्यूल्स। व्हाट आर शेड्यूल्स? व्हाट आर ट्रांजैक्शंस? व्हाट इज़ अ सीरियल शेड्यूल? व्हाट आर नॉन सीरियल शेड्यूल्स? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सीरियलाइजेबिलिटी? हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू हेल्प अस टू मेक आर डेटाबेस स्टेट कंसिस्टेंट? इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू चेक our schedule is conflict serializable or not, and one method to find equivalent serial schedule we have discussed was, you know, with the help of precedence graph and topological ordering. Today we are going to discuss about view serializability and its testing. How we are going to check whether the schedule of concurrent transaction is a view serializable or not? How you are going to check for that? If we talk in practical terms, there do not exist an efficient testing technique that could tell you whether your schedule is serializable or not. Although we could manually check, you know, the conditions that we have to meet for a schedule to be view serializable, but it is only possible, as I discussed, that you could only check for a schedule to be view serializable only if the number of transactions and instructions are very small. But if the transactions are increasing, and if you know the number of instructions in each transaction is increasing, it becomes exponentially cost effective. It will have computation cost in exponential order to find out, to check for each of the conditions in each of the pair that could exist in the number of transactions and their instructions for view serializability. If you remember, we have generally three conditions for view serializability. First was that if we went to check whether two schedules are view equivalent or not, we need to check for the same transaction, that is doing the initial read for a particular data item in both the schedule, it should be same. Similarly, the final write of the same data item should be done by same transaction in both the schedule. And third one was the order in which a read has been performed after a write of a transaction, the schedule or in the sequence of execution should be same in both the schedules. Only then we could say that those two schedules are view equivalent. And as we have talked earlier also, if one of the schedule is found to be serial schedule, then we say the schedule, another one is known as view serializable. Now to check that interleaved schedule, whether it is view serializable or not, we have to check these three conditions with each pair of instructions in all the transaction. That could be exponentially costly for our algorithms to check. So we generally use a term for such type of problems is NP complete problems, that simply tell you that the problem is so much hard that we are not getting an efficient solution for the problem. But still we are having some condition, the sufficient condition that we could say whether the schedule is not view serializable, whether the schedule may or may not, you know, we could have a possibility of view serializability. Or we could say that, if you remember, while we were discussing about testing of conflict serializability, we have shown the fact that if a schedule is found to be conflict serializable, it will be view serializable always. So such type of conditions we could impose on a schedule. If they are found to be correct, we could say it is view serializable, or the reverse may happen, that it is surely not view serializable. But still we are having some method, some kind of hidden trial method, or we could say some inefficient method that could work better in small problems. Today we are going to discuss some of them. First method, as we have discussed in case of conflict serializability also, whenever you have been provided a schedule, you have to check it first for conflict serializability. If the schedule is found to be conflict serializable, you could simply write it that it is view serializable schedule also. You need not to check further conditions of view serializability on that particular schedule that has been found for conflict serializable. So this I have considered your method number one to check whether your schedule is view serializable or not. Second schedule to just verify to be sure that it is not view serializable. In any case, there is no possibility of being a schedule to be view serializable, is to check for blind write operation. If you remember, a blind write operation is simply when we are doing writing on a data item without reading its previous value. Simply, if we are having some transactions and I am directly performing while starting that transaction, while the first or second instruction or in between, whenever you are accessing your data item first time, you are directly writing on that data item instead of first reading it, then changing its value. So we are just, without checking what was its value earlier, we are just blindly writing the value. That's why it's known as blind write operation. So if any of the schedule do not have any blind write operation, then it is surely not view serializable. Please note, we are not saying that if it is not having any blind write, it is a conflict serializable. No, it is not the thing. We are just listing the methods for view serializability properties. If it is not having any blind write operation, you will simply say it is not view serializable, right? So these methods will help you to identify whether your schedule is view serializable or not. Both of these methods, out of one, it is giving you a way which is telling you that surely the schedule is view serializable if it is conflict serializable. Second method will tell if the schedule is not having any blind write, it is not view serializable for sure. Third method is somewhat similar to your conflict serializability test by precedence graph. We generally draw a dependency graph to find its view equivalent serial schedule. As we have discussed earlier also, when we are checking the three conditions, we are trying to find out a schedule that is view equivalent to a particular schedule. If that schedule with which we are trying to find out equivalent or view equivalent is found to be a serial schedule, then we say that it is view serializable. So here we will try to find such a serial schedule to which it could be view equivalent. That means to have our properties being satisfied, and if anyhow I am able to convert that to a serial schedule with my three conditions satisfied, if it is possible, then I'll say it is a view serializable schedule. Again, I am saying the methods that we are discussing are not very much efficient. Over here also, when we are going to draw a graph of dependencies among the concurrent transactions in the schedule, is generally very difficult to draw that if we are having a number of transactions. Not to worry, we will discuss these three methods in detail with the help of an example. So let us discuss. Simply, when you are drawing the dependency graph for this method particularly, you have to check whether it is having a cycle or not. If there is no cycle, as you have done in your precedence graph for conflict serializability, there is a dependency graph in view serializability. So if you do not found any cycle, we will say that the schedule is view serializable. I hope the three methods are clear to you. You will get more clarity when we will discuss the examples. Consider this example. So the schedule is having three transactions running concurrently, and we are having a number of, I hope these notations are clear to you. Over here, RA is showing you a read operation done on data item named A. WA is showing you the write operation on data item A. First thing, all the instructions has been performed on the same data item A. So we are having a number of possibilities to check for our pair of instruction for which we need to check are three conditions for view serializability. Anyhow, if I want to check for this particular example or any example that you are in hand for checking of view serializability, we will proceed with those three methods. That means I will first try to find whether it is conflict serializable or not. Although you can do that also only by looking at your transactions and instructions by checking for the conditions of your conflict serializability, or you could take help of precedence graph in any manner. You will proceed to next step only if it is not found to be conflict serializable. If at very first time you get that this schedule is conflict serializable, simply you could write that it is view serializable. If it is not found to be conflict serializable, then you will check for your second condition, that is it having a blind write or not. Yes, it is having a blind write. So we cannot say that it is not view serializable. Still, we are having a possibility that it is view serializable. So then we will move forward our third step by drawing its dependency graph. So let's check for its conflict serializability. For the conflict serializability, if you remember, we have to look for the non-conflicting operations to be swapped in sequence. That was done to, if we are not choosing precedence graph for the testing of conflicting serializability. So over here, majorly all the instructions except the read operation or same data items are conflicting instructions. So it is hard to swap the instructions to change it to a serial schedule. So we'll try with the precedence graph. We'll simply mention all the conflicting instructions, as we can see over here is in your transaction T1 and T2, one is read operation and another one is write operation, and both are on same data item. So it is a conflicting operation. That means it will help you to get an error in precedence graph from your T1 to T2. In which conflict occurs first. Similarly, this pair is also a conflicting pair. Similarly, this pair is also a conflicting pair. Similarly, this pair is also a conflicting pair. So by doing these conflicting, or by finding out these conflicting pair, we could simply attach an edge in your precedence graph, as we have done earlier also in our test for conflict serializability. So simply by doing, or by finding our, you know, possible conflicting instructions, we are having these edges that we need to draw in our graph, and your precedence graph will look something like this. So over here, since we are having three transactions, we are having three nodes as shown over here, and we have drawn these edges based upon the conflicting pair of operation that we have found in our transaction or in our schedule. So by looking at the precedence graph, it is very much clear that it is containing a cycle, and when a precedence graph contains a cycle, it is for sure not a conflict serializable schedule. So for this particular schedule, since it is not conflict serializable, so we cannot say whether it is view serializable or not. We have to proceed for our next step for blind writes. So simply your transactions are having transaction number, you know, 2 as contains a blind write, because it is writing the value of data item without reading it. So we can say that schedule surely not view serializable possibility is cancelled. That means it may or may not be view serializable. So we'll try for third method by drawing the dependency graph. Your drawing dependency graph simply shows that if which transaction is reading the initial value of your data item, from there your edge will coming out, from there the edges will be in outgoing form, and the transaction who is finally writing the values of, or who is doing the final write of that particular data item, it will have all incoming edges from the transactions or from the second law transaction. Similarly, in between, when write and read operations are being performed, which read has been done by which write operation, the arrows or the edges will be drawn in that sequence. So just trying to draw the dependency graph. These are simply the instructions that are showing you the sequence in the schedule also. Over here, when T1 is the first instruction or transaction, sorry, that is reading the value of A, and T2 firstly updates A after reading of T1. So we are getting an error or a dependency of T2 by T1. That means T2 is getting the values, but earlier it was fetched or read by T1. So we are getting an error between node T1 and T2. Similarly, we'll try to get arrows between T2 and T3, and our dependency graph will look something like this. If we talk about a cycle in this dependency graph, it is clear that it do not contains a cycle. So at this step, we could say that it is a view serializable schedule. But as you can see, to find such dependency in such a small number of instructions is itself very difficult, and for an algorithm it will rather it's not efficient, it is rather more difficult for any algorithm to check for such dependencies or to draw for such graph. It is possible, I'm not saying it's not possible, but it will not be an efficient method. So this was all about how we could check our view serializability. Keeping in mind that we have to try first for conflict serializability. If we found a schedule to be conflict serializable, you need not to step ahead for checking of your view serializability. Another method was with the help of blind write. If it is not containing any blind write, you could simply say that for sure it is not view serializer. But if it is having blind write, it may be view serializable or it may not be view serializable. And third thing is with the help of drawing dependency graph. So till now we have discussed everything about conflict and view serializability. I hope today's lecture is clear to you all. Still, if you are having some query, please put in the comments. In next lecture, we will proceed to our another branch of schedules, recoverable and cascadeless schedules. Till then, thank you very much. Stay safe at your home. Thanks again for listening.